When atom was just discovered, many models were given. Welcome to Science Pedagogics, Science Made Easier. And today's topic is Niels Bohr view of atomic model. Before proceeding, do like, share and subscribe this channel as your support matters a lot in this journey. And let us know about other topics you want us to make video on.
Namaskar children, how are you? I hope you all are fine. Children, today we are going to discuss one more model given by Niels Bohr that explains the structure of atom. But before starting this topic, let us have a quick recap which we have already studied in previous lectures. Children, in our previous lecture, we have discussed the model given by J.J. Thomson as well as Rutherford's model of an atom. Rutherford performed the famous gold foil experiment. Then we studied about the observations, conclusions and postulates. That model was accepted by scientists for a long period of time. But there was major drawback of Rutherford's model that it could not be able to explain the stability of atom. The reason is only that one. According to Rutherford, he told that electrons revolve around the nucleus in circular orbits. And when any of the particles revolve in circular orbit, then it shows accelerated motion. It means it continuously loses some amount of energy by revolving around the center. So after some time, when it loses whole amount of its energy, electron would be fall inside the nucleus and then there would be no existence of atom. So that major drawback to overcome the objections raised against this model, means raised against Rutherford's model, Niels Bohr put forward some of the postulates, and these postulates are known as Niels Bohr's model of an atom. The first postulate which was given by Niels Bohr, that electrons revolve around the nucleus in certain means specific energy levels. Means according to him, electrons revolve around the nucleus in specific shells. He named these shells as energy levels, as well as these shells are also known as orbits. Means orbits, shells and energy levels, these are same. He numbered these energy levels as n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. And he designated these levels as K, L, M, N and dot dot. It means if we are talking about K shell, we are talking about the first shell of the nucleus. Okay. For example, you can see in this diagram that here is in the center, there is a nucleus and then the first energy level, second energy level and third one. The first energy level is also known as K shell, second one that is also known as L shell and third one is known as M shell and so on. Second postulate which was given by Niels Bohr, that when electrons revolve in these orbits, means K, L, M and so on, they have a specific amount of energy. And they do not radiate that energy, they do not emit that energy. So these shells or these orbits are also known as stationary orbits, S-T-A-T-I-O-N-A-R-Y. These are also known as stationary orbits. Next thing is that one, that it is not possible that electron can be found in any of the orbit. There are certain rules which were followed by these electrons. For that one, the angular momentum of that particular orbit, that is represented by L, it should be equal to nh upon 2 pi. It means if for a given orbit, it's the angular momentum of electron is equal to nh upon 2 pi, only in that condition, the founding of possibility to found the electrons in this orbital is maxima. Okay, and in this formula, I'll represent angular momentum. And H is the Planck's constant. Its value is 6.26. Its value is 6.26 into 10 raised to the power minus 34 joule into second. Okay. So these are the three postulates. Let us discuss some more postulates. The fourth one is that when external energy is provided to electrons, then these electrons will jump to the higher energy level. It means when energy is provided to electrons, these electrons will jump to the higher energy level. It means electron will move from K shell to L shell and then L shell to M shell. Okay, and they absorb particular amount of energy. After some time, when the same electron, when the electron will lose energy, then it will emit the same amount of energy in the form of spectrum. And this electron will come back to the lower energy level. If external energy is provided to atom from in the form of electricity, in the form of heat, then these electrons jump to higher energy level. Okay, and they absorb the same amount of energy. After some time, when they lose energy, they again come back to the ground state. So the energy difference, that is equal, delta E is equal to E2 minus E1, which is further equal to H nu. Here nu is the frequency of energy because they emit the same energy having the same frequency, and E2 is the energy of higher orbit and E1 is the energy of orbit that is of low energy level, and delta E is the difference. These are some of the postulates given by the Bose. So if we draw an atomic model given by Niels Bohr, so we can draw, this is center of the atom. These are the various shells, for example, K shell. This is the second shell, that is L, and here it is one more shell that is known as M shell. So now we can label the diagram. This is nucleus. Okay, it is first shell, that is also known as K shell, second shell, that is L shell, and next one is M shell. Now, after Rutherford, Niels Bohr gave some of the postulates, and that postulates he was able to explain the structure of atom, especially related with hydrogen. Means Niels Bohr done the experiments only for hydrogen atoms, and this experiment or this postulates of the atom are also able to explain the hydrogen spectrum, means the atomic spectrum formed by hydrogen atom. So now let us discuss some of the successes of Rutherford's model. First one, that this model could be able to explain the stability of atom. Means with the help of this model, now scientists would be able to explain the stability of atom. Okay. Second thing, that he could able to calculate the amount of energy that is associated with particular orbit. And that amount of energy can be calculated by using the formula, that is E is equal to minus K square 2 pi square ME4 divided by N square H square. With the help of this formula, he would be able to calculate the amount of energy associated with the orbit. Now here K is Coulomb's constant and its value is 9 into 10 raised to the power 9, whereas pi its value 3.14. then m is mass of electron, m is equal to mass of electron, okay, and its value is 9.1 multiplied by 10 raised to the power minus 31 kg. Done. The next is E. E is the that E is equal to charge on electron and its value is 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 coulombs. N is equal to quantum number, means the value of N may be 1, 2, 3, up to on and so on. And H is again Planck's constant, then its value is 6.26 into 10 raised to the power minus 34 joule into second. Now by putting the values of all these constants and variables in this formula, we are able to calculate the total amount of energy that is associated with the given orbit. Okay. And the value is equal to, that is E is equal to 1312 minus 1312 divided by N square kilojoule. Okay. Kilojoule per mole. This is the calculate value. अब इस वीडियो में हम इसकी कैलकुलेशन डेरिवेशन नहीं है, दैट इज द वैल्यू एंड दिस वैल्यू इट हेल्प्स टू सॉल्व द वेरियस न्यूमेरिकल्स दैट इज रिलेटेड विद द ऑर्बिट्स. द नेक्स्ट सक्सेस इज दैट वी कुड बी एबल टू कैलकुलेट द रेडियस ऑफ द ऑर्बिट. मतलब इस फॉर्मूले से जो है इसके नील बोर्स के पोस्टुलेट से, इसके मॉडल से ना सिर्फ एनर्जी ही कैलकुलेट की जा सकती है, बट वी कैन ऑल्सो कैलकुलेट द रेडियस ऑफ द ऑर्बिट एंड इट्स वैल्यू इज दैट इज रिलेटेड विद 0.529 एंगस्ट्रॉम पर एटम. ओके, दैट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ द रेडियस. नेक्स्ट थिंग इज दैट Bohr's model would be able to explain the spectrum formed by hydrogen atom. Means, with the help of this model, he could be able to explain the hydrogen spectrum. Now, what is hydrogen spectrum? Hydrogen spectrum kya hai? For example, as we have discussed that this is the Bohr's model for hydrogen. Okay. This is the center part that we can name it as nucleus. This is the first shell in which the electron is present. When external energy is provided to this atom, then this electron will get energy and it will jump to the higher energy level. That we all know that it will jump to the higher energy level. So what would happen after some time, that when it moves to higher energy level, it again come back to its ground state. The first shell, that is known as ground state. तो जब ये energy को emit करेगा वापस, तो ये ground state पे जब आएगा, तो ये energy जो emit होती है, वो किसकी form में होती है? Spectrum की form में. Energy is emitted in the form of spectrum. And what is spectrum? Spectrum is the radiation, photons radiations. मीन्स रेडिएशन की फॉर्म में एनर्जी एमिट होती है. रेडिएशन क्या है? बंडल ऑफ फोटॉन्स. तो पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट की एनर्जी जो एमिट होती है, दैट इज क्वांटाइज्ड एनर्जी. दैट इज क्वांटाइज्ड एनर्जी. और ये जो स्पेक्ट्रम फॉर्मेशन होता है, ये एनर्जी रिलीज, जब इलेक्ट्रॉन वापस आएगा तो पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट की जो एनर्जी रिलीज करेगा इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रेडिएशन, तो ये रेडिएशन जो है वो स्पेक्ट्रम का फॉर्मेशन करते हैं. और ये स्पेक्ट्रम जो है वो अल्ट्रा वायलेट रीजन में, विजिबल रीजन में, देन इंफ्रारेड रीजन में, डिफरेंट डिफरेंट रीजन में पर्टिकुलर वेव लेंथ की लाइट जो है वो एमिट होती है. एंड द एनर्जी इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ क्वांटाइज्ड फॉर्म. ओके, सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस मॉडल ही कुड बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन द स्पेक्ट्रम, हाइड्रोजन स्पेक्ट्रम, दैट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द एटोमिक स्पेक्ट्रम. In our next video, we will discuss in detail about the hydrogen spectrum and what are the radiation, what type of radiations are emitted during this absorption and radiation of the energy, emission of the energy. ये सब पर्टिकुलर एक अलग से वीडियो में, नेक्स्ट वीडियो में हम इसके स्पेक्ट्रम को स्टडी करेंगे. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द successes of Rutherford's model, that he could be able to explain the stability of atom. Second one, that energy can be calculated, that is associated with particular orbit. And then next is we are able to calculate the radius of the orbit also. He could be able to explain the spectrum, hydrogen spectrum, means the spectrum formed by hydrogen atom when external energy is provided to it. Now next is that Bohr's model was not the perfect model. Still, there was some of the confusion, some of the points, doubts that were left out in the mind of scientists. So what are the limitations of Rutherford's model? Now we will discuss its limitations. The first limitation was that one, that Niels Bohr's model was applicable only for atoms containing one electron. Okay, it means we can say that he did research work, he proposed the model only that is applicable for hydrogen atom. So that model was not applicable for atoms having more electrons, not applicable for large size electrons, large size atoms, or we can say atoms containing more electrons, not applicable. Okay. Second one is that when we provide energy to atom, जब atom को energy provide की जाती है, तो electron jump to the higher energy level में jump कर जाएंगे. They again come back to ground state after some time. Then they emit the particular amount of energy in the form of radiation. और उन radiation से spectrum form होता है. जब एक high magnetic field अगर उस समय spectrum के ऊपर apply किया जाए, तो particular जो lines होती हैं, जो spectrum, for example, these are the spectrum lines. तो ये particular single line जो है, वो further minute lines में डिवाइड हो जाती है. एंड दिस इफेक्ट इज कॉल्ड एज Zeeman इफेक्ट. दिस इफेक्ट इज कॉल्ड एज Zeeman इफेक्ट. आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग अगेन, जस्ट लिसन केयरफुली, दैट व्हेन एनर्जी इज प्रोवाइडेड टू एटम, ओके, इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विल मूव टू द हायर एनर्जी लेवल. आफ्टर सम टाइम दे विल अगेन कम बैक टू ग्राउंड स्टेट. And they emit the particular amount of energy in the form of radiation. Radiation की form में वो energy को emit करते हैं और उन radiation से जो है वो spectrum का formation होता है. Okay? अब इस spectrum के अंदर जो है particular wavelength की lines हैं, particular wavelength की particular colors की lines हैं. जब इस spectrum के ऊपर high magnetic field apply किया जाएगा, तो उस condition में ये जो lines हैं वो further minute lines में divide हो जाती है. And this effect is called as Zeeman effect. And he could not be able to explain that why these lines will split out. कि जो lines बनती हैं ये तो उसने बता दिया, but ये split out क्यों हो जाती हैं उसका reason वो explain नहीं कर पाया. Now next limitation is that in the same condition, हमने एटम को एनर्जी प्रोवाइड की, इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हायर एनर्जी लेवल पे गए, आफ्टर सम टाइम दे अगेन कम बैक टू देयर ग्राउंड स्टेट, दे एमिट that energy in the form of spectrum, in the form of radiation, or radiation से spectrum का formation. जब इस spectrum के ऊपर, जो spectrum का formation हुआ है, इस पर high voltage electric field apply किया जाए, अगर electric field जो है वो apply किया जाए इसके ऊपर, तो again same behavior ये lines show करती है कि जो lines बनती है spectrum की वो split out हो जाती है, और उसको भी वो नहीं समझा पाए कि why these lines of spectrum again split out into minute lines. And here that effect is called as Stark effect. It means Bohr's model ki help se jo hai Zeeman effect or Stark effect ko bhi explain nahi kiya ja sakta tha. Clear? Now the next limitation is that one, after some time a new scientist, that is de Broglie. De Broglie is the name of the scientist. अब De Broglie ने क्या कहा कि लाइट जो है जैसे ड्यूअल नेचर शो करती है, सेम उसी तरीके से जो माइक्रोस्कोपिक पार्टिकल्स हैं वो भी ड्यूअल नेचर शो करते हैं। क्लियर। डी ब्रॉगली नाम के साइंटिस्ट ने उस समय डिस्कवरी की कि एज लाइट शोज ड्यूअल नेचर इन द सेम वे पार्टिकल्स ऑल्सो शोज ड्यूअल नेचर। इट मीन्स जो माइन्यूट पार्टिकल्स हैं, इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हैं, प्रोटॉन्स, न्यूट्रॉन्स जो हैं, ये पार्टिकल्स भी वेव नेचर भी शो करते हैं। पार्टिकल नेचर तो शो करते ही करते हैं, एज वेल एज जो है सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स वेव नेचर भी शो करते हैं। तो ये जो दोनों बातें हैं कि पार्टिकल भी ड्यूअल नेचर शो करता है, लाइट भी ड्यूअल नेचर शो करती है, ये पोस्टुलेट्स, ये पॉइंट्स जो हैं वो कोर्स एक्सप्लेन नहीं कर पाया। ही कुड नॉट बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन दीज पोस्टुलेट्स दैट हाउ इट इज पॉसिबल। क्लियर। नेक्स्ट लिमिटेशन, दैट वाज द फिफ्थ लिमिटेशन। अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट वन व्हाट हैपेंड बेटा, कि देयर इज वन अनसर्टेनिटी प्रिंसिपल दैट इज गिवन बाय हाइजेनबर्ग। हाइजेनबर्ग भी एक अनदर साइंटिस्ट थे, तो हाइजेनबर्ग ने एक अनसर्टेनिटी प्रिंसिपल दिया था। अब ये अनसर्टेनिटी प्रिंसिपल क्या है कि कोई भी अगर सब माइक्रोस्कोपिक या सब माइक्रोस्कोपिक एलिमेंट है, कुछ कुछ भी हो सकता है, इट मे बी प्रोटोन, इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, अगर ये मोशन में है, मीन्स वाइल दे आर इन मोशन, then because these particles show wave nature also, and waves जो होती हैं, waves क्या हैं? Waves delocalized हैं। Waves क्या होती हैं? Delocalized, यानी अगर हम पता करना चाहें कि ये waves कहाँ हैं, particle को तो हम particular उसकी position को locate कर सकते हैं, but अगर वही particle wave की form में travel कर रहा है और वेव्स डीलोकलाइज्ड होती हैं, इट मींस हम इन वेव्स को नहीं पता लगा सकते कि इनकी एग्जैक्ट लोकेशन क्या है। दैट इज हाइजेनबर्ग अनसर्टेनिटी प्रिंसिपल। दैट इज हाइजेनबर्ग अनसर्टेनिटी प्रिंसिपल। अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट वन, किसी भी मूविंग पार्टिकल की एग्जैक्ट लोकेशन पता करना बहुत मुश्किल है, अगर वो पार्टिकल जो है वो वेव नेचर भी शो करता है। अगर कोई भी पार्टिकल वेव नेचर भी शो करता है तो उसकी लोकेशन को ट्रेस आउट करना मुश्किल है, एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज हाइजेनबर्ग अनसर्टेनिटी प्रिंसिपल। सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द ड्रॉबैक्स। वन मोर ड्रॉबैक विच वी विल स्टडी, दैट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ बोर्स मॉडल इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू एक्सप्लेन द जियोमेट्री ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल। वी ऑल नो दैट एटम्स रिएक्ट विद ईच अदर and they form molecule, okay, and molecules are fixed shape, they are having fixed shape, to jo molecules ki geometry hai yani arrangement hai atoms ka ek molecule mein, usko Niels Bohr's ke jo model hai usse explain karna possible nahi tha. So these are some of the drawbacks of Niels Bohr's model. We will again revise that. First drawback is that one, first is that geometry, that stability of atom explain कर सकता था, but applicable किसके लिए था? सिर्फ hydrogen atom के लिए applicable था। second one, could not able to explain Zeeman effect, Zeeman effect को explain नहीं किया जा सकता। third one, that could not able to explain Stark effect। Stark effect मतलब अगर किसी भी atom को energy provide की जाएगी और एनर्जी प्रोवाइड करने के बाद इलेक्ट्रॉन हायर एनर्जी लेवल पे जंप कर जाएगा, अगेन आफ्टर सम टाइम इट विल कम बैक टू द ग्राउंड लेवल। ग्राउंड लेवल पे आने के लिए वो जो पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट की एनर्जी उसने एब्जॉर्ब की थी उसको वापस एमिट किएगा। एमिट किस फॉर्म में करेगा? रेडिएशन के फॉर्म में। रेडिएशन कैसे निकलेंगे? स्पेक्ट्रम फॉर्मेशन होगा। अगर हम उस स्पेक्ट्रम जो फॉर्म हुआ है उस स्पेक्ट्रम पर पर्टिकुलर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड अप्लाई करें तो जो स्पेक्ट्रम की लाइन्स हैं वो स्प्लिट आउट हो जाते हैं, और वो स्प्लिट आउट क्यों हो जाते हैं? दैट इज स्टार्क इफेक्ट, और स्टार्क इफेक्ट को एक्सप्लेन करना पॉसिबल नहीं था। द फोर्थ लिमिटेशन, दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू डी ब्रॉगली, डी ब्रॉगली ने कहा था कि लाइट जैसे ड्यूअल नेचर शो करती है, इसी तरीके से सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स यानी जो माइक्रोस्कोपिक पार्टिकल्स हैं वो भी ड्यूअल नेचर शो करते हैं, वो पार्टिकल नेचर भी शो करते हैं, वेव नेचर भी। That could not be able to explain with the help of Bohr's model. फिफ्थ वन हाइजेनबर्ग अनसर्टेनिटी प्रिंसिपल जब इंट्रोड्यूस हुआ था तो उसको भी बोस मॉडल की हेल्प से जो है एक्सप्लेन नहीं किया जा सकता. क्लियर? दैट कुड ऑल्सो नॉट बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन. एंड द लास्ट वन दैट विद द हेल्प ऑफ बोस मॉडल द ज्योमेट्री ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स कुड नॉट बी एक्सप्लेन्ड. Geometry of molecules could not be explained. So these are some of the drawbacks or limitations, but with the help of that model, Bohr's model, we could able to explain the stability of atom. So children, this is all about today. In our next video, we will discuss more about Heisenberg's uncertainty principle as well as de Broglie dual nature of light as well as particles, because these two concepts are the basis of quantum mechanical model of an atom that was introduced later on. So till then, bye and have a nice day. If you have any doubt, then write it in the comment box so that I am able to help you out to clear your doubts. Thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. And इस chapter से related और videos आपकी screen पे shown है. And please keep updated yourself about our further videos.